Yesterday's 2 smooth stone anniversary of Hurricane Michael came and went without a big bang from our maker on the world scene. Amazing how he continues to shorten the days through afflicting his second son of his holy anointing oil in your stead, the substitution sacrifice that he set up through his 2 sons of his holy anointing oil. Truly amazing. However, I can assure you that this substitution affliction will come to an end. The testimony of his word says so. Amazing, though, that I thought, well, he tells us in his only begotten son told us in Matthew chapter 24 that once the affliction that will be in those days ends, then immediately or straightway afterwards, you're going to see the sign of the Son of Adam and dual heavens and such. And truly amazing, because I realize when this toothache ends, he keeps on, he's going to let this go. And of course, I thought it was the 21 days of Daniel's affliction that came and went. But he did cause the tooth to subside at the end of those 21 days. And for about a 20-hour period of time, it's pretty amazing. But then it hit back when I was doing a video that next day on 8-8 waypoint. It just hit back hard. By the time I finished the video, it just started hitting, and I could hardly finish getting the upload done and when it's done. But and it's a debility that there's 2 strokes. He's hit me on the right side and the left side. I haven't really talked about the difference, but the right side is more of a standard toothache. I mean, right now it hurts, but I mean, it's not debilitating. I mean, it's just it's swelled up. It's got a infection pocket and a big abscess, I guess, in there, and it's loose and it feels like it come out. It's painful, but it's even painful now. But it's not the pain that I talk about when he gives me relief from both. When he gives me the relief for those 7 days later, when I thought it was after 28 days, he gave me the relief for a few hours. And then after the 35 days, which was pre-8/22, he gave me relief again, most of the way through the Sabbath yesterday. And then all of a sudden it started hitting me again. And not the kind of relief he gives me with the videos. He gives me relief for the videos to get it done, or with the trucks, with the rolling thing. He gives me relief to get it done, but it's different. He gives me just relief. I mean, it's like it's healed, but then it comes back, and because the affliction has an end. But yet each of those times he's marked it. And the 21 days of Daniel's affliction, I thought, of course, was it. And then, of course, you have, because that's Michael, Daniel chapter 10 for Michael. It's being uncovered to you and such. But the 28 sevens of Leviticus 26, I thought the 4 sevens of the 28 days of Leviticus, I thought was it. But then he showed, no, there's actually 5 sevens, because it's sevenfold, and he says he's going to do it again sevenfold and again sevenfold. So there's actually 35 days. So that preceded 8/22 on 8/21, which are amazing waypoints, both of them. But then he gave me relief again that third time. And then here we go again. So what's it going to be? Is it, you see, the prophecies for sending me before, your face like in the revelations of his 2 sons, you should prophesy again. Man of the Feast, a.k.a. Haggai, a second time. Different prophecies, even a second time. But in Revelations of his 2 sons, it's the second time before kings and such in the world, which is just these videos. But before the world's faces, and the most explosive media network ever hit the world, I'm sure YouTube is. It's quite amazing, but not his work. It doesn't go out. It would, like I said, if I showed some woman's breast or something, it would go out. But anyway, dual 21 days, the second time, 42 days. Well, you know, already today's already day number 37, so only 5 more days after today. But had some rough goes today. Like I said, the left side, when it comes on, it's debilitating. Thanks to the man from Scotland, we got a solar generator and a freezer that I can we freeze juice packs, and I can put it on the outside of my cheek. And after some time, sometimes it takes quite a while, but it'll subside. Sometimes it'll just take 10 minutes type of thing, and it will subside. And it's amazing. It'd be 42, 3 sets of 14 generations to bring forth his only begotten son of the world. 42 generations. You got all sorts of things tied in. The 42 months of 3.5 years. Space of a silence from his dual heavens is 3.5 days. Dual spaces of dual spaces is 14 days, 3 sets of 14, 42 days. Again, a second time, second set of Daniel's 21 days. Will it be? I believe so. It'll take us to 8/28, and that's an amazing waypoint too. I'll expand upon that a little bit, and probably another video is coming up. But the affliction will come to an end. The testimony of His word says so. He's gonna. He talks about being incurable, even with the channels or something. You talk about a root. Teeth have roots. You know, they go like even call it a root canal when you have it done with the dentist or whatever. But the canals of medicine, the healing canals and different things, and not healing me, and how that ties into the heap of the witness Gilead and such, and the virgin daughter of Israel is not going to have the healing bond because if you stay in, it's going to be your virgin daughter of Egypt. If you stay in the captivity, you're not going to be healed. And talks about the canals there too. It's translated cured there in Jeremiah 46. But everything has symbolism. Jeremiah 46, where it's located with the 46 stones, everything. He's put the, you know, people saying, well, man put the chapter and verse numbers there. He's not in control of everything, folks. It's amazing. All of it's amazing. But like I said, the relief He gives me to do these videos or to make the treks the rolling things, sometimes it's, I mean, when I do the rolling things, it usually starts by the time I get back, before I, as I get near, or when I'm down there filling up the waters, He'll give me, at the depot, He'll give me, He'll start to come back again, but during the trek, typically, He gives me, it might be mild or medium, but it doesn't get strong until I get back, and like get done with the videos, He usually lets me get back to camp, except that one day, particularly, after He gave me that about 20 hours of relief, He hit me pretty hard right there. I had a hard time getting back, but I don't think I had any ice with me that day. So anyway, I think it was hot, and I thought the ice might melt, and plus I'd had the relief. I thought it was healed, so because it felt like it was healed. So I didn't bring any ice with me, but it was tough. But anyway, but immediately after the affliction that will be in those days, the sun and the stars, the moon is going to go dark, and the moon's not going to give her light. Folks, it's real, real. But yesterday on the 822 waypoint, they said no fireworks, no big bang. Last night's presidential debate, just crazy stuff. Shows the filth of all of both parties, but it's just asinine. The whole thing is asinine. I'm not going to go into that. But yesterday, day number three, which I thought finished 7:34 a.m., 3 days and three nights for the sign of the dove in the belly of the ocean, the belly of the earth. And that ties into day number 390 of Operation Olive Branches, 828 I'm telling you about, strong number belly, 990. But 3 days and three nights in the belly of the earth, the sign of the dove, but ties into this restored counter stuff I'll expand on a little bit. But day number three yesterday of Armenia and Azerbaijan, I don't know, probably pronounce it wrong, their war. Now, the war had been going on since really 1988. Stuff stopped. They had a peace treaty or something in 1994. In 2016, they had a little flare-up, and a lot of people got killed, but Turkey shot down a jet yesterday on day three. But day number three, lining up on that third day yesterday, because, of course, keep in mind, they're ahead of our time zone, so it would have been, as I said, 7:34 a.m. ended the 3 days and three nights, but He continued to shorten the days by afflicting me in your stead. Of course, He kept me from being afflicted with a toothache until most of the way through the day, which was a treat for the Sabbath, but boy, He hit me in later in the day. But yesterday was a remarkable waypoint. Things like Silver Trump Assembly number 341, strong number for enemies, 341, you're His enemies because you live in rebellion to Him. Testimony of His word says so. But 9/11 plus 341 is yesterday. 9/11, our Maker's restored calendar. 9/11, 5777, the first time that He and I were reviled per Isaiah chapter 8, is in Meher Shalal Kush Baz prophecy. On account of the manner He sent forth the Manuel Manchild, Meher Shalal Kush Baz, and his siblings. First time He and I reviled, that prophecy was 9/11, 5777, plus 1061. Strong number for first fruits. Talk about 144,000 first fruits. Yesterday was day number 21,000 for the 21 days of the toothache. 21,144, those 144 first fruits. Lining up on it that way. 1061 from the first time I was reviled for first fruits. You think you can make it up, folks? You just can't. But if Jeroboam's eighth day, the symbolism He put in that, why your enemies to Him, profaning His Sabbath is the point of times, of course, stealing from Him, hewing out cisterns that don't hold His living waters, forsaking His fountain of living waters, setting His name falsely and stuff. But this Jeroboam's eighth day, profaning His appointed times. But I had a vision I'm going to go into in this video a little bit later. But the night before was the 84th night of the shofars. Last night was 85th. I'll expand upon that. But yesterday, day number 253 for Uriah and Zechariah, the faithful witness twins. Today will be day number 254. maybe expand upon that too if I think about it, but that's a pretty big too. But 253 parallel and 250 princes went with Korah. Korah 251, Aaron 252. Matter of fact, today's that most by far the most expensive box of wine, $252. I think it was after the $40 that came out of the naked bank thing, but whatever, it was $252 charge on the account, which by far the last box will begin to be drank tonight with gold label. I might put a picture of that on at one of these videos, but something else, that last 12th box, I mean, taking us to the 168th bottle, 172nd, with and 170 of them being drank, with two of them being used to wash my persuasion, the blood of the grapes, and significance of 178, and counting the 168, counting, taking away the first four bottles that we're drinking with the mountains of Ararat, curse reverse bottle, going back to 721, come and drink waypoint last year. All remarkable, all symbolism's remarkable in all this. But Korah, 250 plus Korah, 251, Aaron, 250, and there was a 200. There was another man that, I guess, what they call it when with the politicians, they say he recused himself. He recused himself, but the other two got the ground opened up. So in all, there was 252, 253, 255. But there's 254 would be minus that man who recused himself, and the two Abiram and Deborah that the earth swallowed up and swallowed them up. But truly amazing with all that. But speaking of 9/11, steamboat number 118 the other day, plus 69 hours and 59 minutes. This is just an example. I don't talk about very many of these in the video because they're nuggets for me. And I mean, but I'm just going to show you how intricate he is. And this again is nothing, but it was cool. Because it's always cool, but you have to be there, kind of a thing. But I'm going to try to explain that you have to be there, so you might be able to envision it in your mind. But 9/11 the other day, before on 8/21, when I got back from the 80th trek with the rolling thing, which by the way was caused from me getting that $80 refund from Naked Wines, I was able to get the waters delivered. Now since then, Winter and Georgia both sent some money, but I had to use the $80 to meeting the man from Sweden and the man from Scotland. But anyway, 118 plus 69 hours and 59 minutes was yesterday, 7:34 a.m. Morning waypoint of 3 days and three nights coming to an end. That was 2 days and 21 hours and 59 minutes after steamboat number 118, which, of course, is significant. The 220 years, he shortened it into his years, into the 6,000 years, into his year of the ram's horn release of debts last year, and how he tied into the tier of the 1290 and Isaiah 59 and other things, but I'm not going to lie. But 6959, strong number 6959, is used two places. It's one of the two words that's used for helmet. It comes from the other word that means the helmet. But what had happened is I never have heard back from that guy with those eight poured out ones from Adam in Micah chapter 5, or Michael chapter 5. But it looks like a helmet. I told it got four stars on it, but four diamond gold diamonds on it. But it looks like a battle helmet. And that's what this is. One of the places it's used is referred to Saul's helmet that David didn't put on. But I'm talking about that, and then all of a sudden, talking with the wife that's fled in the wilderness upon the dual wings of a great vulture to bring forth the Emmanuel man-child, Meher Shalal Kushbas, Revelation chapter 12. I'm talking to her about it, and then all of a sudden he gives me this arithmetic. So he gave me the arithmetic, and then but I hadn't looked up the Strong's number yet. I think it's how it went, but it says to be there, and I can't. It doesn't really matter which happened first, but anyway, I hadn't looked up the Strong's number yet, so I didn't. It was helmet. I was like, you gotta be kidding me, because I had just finished speaking to her, regardless, about the bottle with the helmet. I can't remember if I looked up the numbers. Yeah, I had to look up the numbers first, because otherwise, how would I look up 69:59? So for the 69 hours and 59 minutes, but we just finished in that interim talking about the helmet that I think is what that is on the bottle, because I still don't know for sure, because I haven't heard back from the wine producer. But last night, last bottle of those eight poured out, which from Adam, that had that helmet on there. Well, you say, well, so what? So what? Coincidence. Really? Hear the next part, folks. Hear the next part. So, because this is about 9/11, this whole thing is about 9/11, and I speak about 9/11 even in that video, the last video, and the reviling, I went ahead and subtracted 822 from 6959 from it, and it turns out that there are 6959 days that encompass 9/11/2001, and yesterday's 822 eighth day of Jeroboam's profane feast, 7:34 a.m. third day, sign of the dove, waypoint. 6959 days. You just can't make it up, and that happens to me continually. I talk about some of them in the videos. Enough of them, you should be amazed. But that happens to me continually every day. I just plug in numbers all day long in the calculator, and it's just everything I plug in works. Now, I didn't know what it was going to be when I plugged it in. I didn't think, oh, I wonder if it's going to be 9/11. Never crossed my mind. But it was of course 9/10, because encompassing it, 9/10/2001. So encompass 9/11, 6959 days. Just when we're talking, right after we're talking about the word helmet. And right after I figured out there's 69 hours and 59 minutes. Like I said, it's present. It always is then. I'm thinking this, and I look it up, and it's that. I'm thinking, it's constant. I say this to the wife, or I speak it in a video. I say Steamboat's going to go off at 9:24, and instead he takes it to 9:34, while I was already, it happened before I spoke that, even I didn't know that, in Steamboat 118, for instance, with that 10 minutes, but it turned out not 10 minutes, 11 minutes, because they changed it to 9:35, and it's just nonstop, and all the symbolism that I talked about with 10 and 11, even in that video. You just can't, it's just no end to it, who could make this up besides the Almighty? Nobody could, and nobody could make that up, 69 hours and 59 minutes later, if it was yesterday, 7:34 a.m. waypoint. You just can't make it up. But he continued to shorten the days, and the affliction continues. But it's all quite incredible. And like I said, I only speak about a small percentage of these details in the videos. But I speak about enough, you should be amazed. But tonight is the first bottle of the last box. The 10th box that was ordered was drank. That was the seven shepherds. The second, go a second time, the second tier of seven shepherds, and eight poured out ones from Adam of Micah chapter 5. He's going to give us over to be afflicted until the time of the birth. Who's he talking about? Who's he talking about? Till the time of the birth. He's going to give us over to be afflicted until the time of the birth. And then he goes on. He's going to deliver us to seven shepherds and eight poured out ones from Adam. There ain't a third tier of that. There's only two tiers of it. Those two boxes. But now, that bottle was drank last night, and it was difficult. But definitely you think, well, how can it be difficult to drink wine? Because of the toothache and stuff. And some of them bottles is just downright tough to even get him drink, but I he's got a schedule because it's a countdown. Now the 15 bottles started, the last 15. Amazing. But from Napa Valley, with that white, it's Ken Diaz is the name of the wine, but Diaz is German for Matthew. Ken Matthews wine, I call it. How that ties into a guy used to write me, Tim, and his friend, his Ken, and different things. And I talked about in other videos, but how the timing of that with that one bottle Ken Matthews I had before. But $252 parallel on those 252 sacrifices that were offered up, 21 a day for those 12 days. Parallel in Daniel's 21 days. But 252 sacrifices when they dedicated the tent in the wilderness. But you can't make it up. But tonight, this wine is from Napa Valley. Napa Valley's burning up, folks. Burning up with the fires out in California and earthquake swarms. Even, I guess, again, I didn't click on the story this morning, but I seen there was a story about some earthquake swarms happening there. But believe me, all this is happening. It's going to be a double punch with that West Coast tsunami and Yellowstone blowing. I really believe that. But today, tonight, bottle number one of those 15 bottles. But truly amazing. The label's truly amazing because it has like a mansion in the background. It has like I thought maybe it's not a mansion, but it's like raised gold print type of thing. And it's quite amazing. The label on that with the vineyards out front, how it ties into his vineyard prophecy and stuff. But today's another amazing waypoint in this. It's night number 318 of the Abraham lamp. 318, he spoke to our ancestors out from the thick dark cloud and the thunderings and the lightnings on 318. Day number 318 in the year is 1118, which is the second dove waypoint when he caused his servant Noah to let loose the dove, the second stroke, out the one cubit dual double lights. Dual double light night number 237 tonight. It goes in swarms, if you will. 237. How I talked about three tiers that the other day. Well, here now we got, and it might have been one of the tiers. I'm not even sure whether in that video, but three tiers of 237 because it goes in swarms, like movement swarms. How he does this, but the stone of Ezel, stone of departure, dual double lights. Noah let loose the dove the first dove, and the first stroke, second stroke, and third stroke, three strokes of 14, dual spaces, 42 nights of this affliction. I'm hoping so. It's hurting good now, but anyway, it's not the debilitating pain yet. I had one of them starting one video, the debilitating pain, and it was pretty tough to get through there. That one not too long ago, but otherwise he's giving me a thing. But here's an amazing one. Today's 9:30 on Satan's calendar. 9:30 of 6,000 last year, year of the Rams' release of death. Isaiah 22, the destruction of Yehweh's house. Ezekiel chapter 7, the hidden place being destroyed, which is that one great evil. The one great evil waypoint, 9:30 of 6,000. Plus Mordecai. Just talked about Mordecai the other day. Mordecai and Esther 3:23 was when the signature ring was given from Haman's hand to Mordecai's hand. So I call it plus 323 days plus Mordecai equals today. Signature ring. That's amazing. The signature ring is the cursed reverse. Going to reverse this. Ararat. You talk about that battle going on now. Today's the fourth day at Ararat. Well, it ain't Ararat, but it's in Armenia where Ararat is. It's 1,700 square foot. Actually, it's in Azerbaijan or whatever. It's there, but it's a 1,700 square foot, square mile, 1,700 square mile mountain chain there that I didn't write down because I wouldn't try to pronounce it if I did. But curse reversed. This is all getting ready to be, the curse is getting ready to be reversed, and believe me, the affliction is going to be removed from me and going to be put on you. So Mount Ararat began with that pomegranate wine on 7:21. Come and drink, waypoint. Yeshua said, come and drink the living waters that flow out of one belly of one who believes. Belly, Strong's number 990, coming up to 828. But anyway, so I subtracted the signature ring, Isaiah 55. I was curious what 55 days prior to today's 9:30 plus Mordecai equals 9:30. Great Meher Shalal Kush Bazmir, meaning 9:30, the one great evil, plus 323 days equals today's 9:30 on Satan's calendar per the Great Meher Shalal Kush Bazmir, Isaiah chapter 8, verse 1. So I subtracted it. I subtracted, listen to these details. Subtracted 55 days, and that was 6:28, which was amazing, which was the 600th day a couple years earlier of me approaching near to him three strokes a day before his house was destroyed. But what was 6:28 55 days ago? You gotta be kidding me. It was day number 930 of Operation Olive Branch. Say what? Did I tell you that this is about 9:30 plus Mordecai, Isaiah 55 signature ring, equals 9:30, Satan's calendar, Great Meher Shalal Kush Bazmir, one great evil plus Mordecai, equals today, 9:30, 55 days prior to today for that Isaiah 55 signature ring that he's given to me back in Greece, was day number 930 of Operation Olive Branch? Can you really make it up? That day was day number 254 with wine, night number 254 with wine. Did I tell you that today is day number 254 that the faithful witness twins, Uriah and Zachariah, have been in the womb? By the way, Mr. Z, yours truly, that racehorse that ran against American Pharaoh then, back then a few years ago when he won the Triple Crown. But Mr. Z's race record was 2-5-4. I always stuck that in my memory. 254, two wins, 5 seconds, and four thirds. But anyway, but that 6:28 waypoint, the two smooth stone anniversary of the 600th day. And by the way, the Hurricane Michael, the Michael wine had in the shipping box is labeled, is number 600, 628. That was two boxes ago, those 13 bottles of Michael wine. Hurricane Michael plus 666 was that day. The mark of the beast that you bear, buying and selling Yehweh's Sabbath. How many of you purchased yesterday? You sure didn't set aside his Sabbath, but how many of you purchased something yesterday? Anything. You got the mark of the beast. Of course you have it, even if you didn't purchase anything. Living in rebellion to the maker, our maker's word, testimony of his word. 666, mark of the beast. He's proven that throughout this. But that day I had in my notes on that day for 9:30 plus 8 months and 28 days. Why did I have that in my notes that day? Because it was for today. 8:28 coming up. Just 5 days from today. But I had 9:30 plus 8:28 equals that day. Equals 6:28. Who can make that up? Day number 42 is 8:28. Who can make it up? This 42nd day I'm talking about with be the 42nd day of my toothache affliction, which it carries over to the next day. 10:05 on Satan's calendar. 10:05, the city smitten waypoint. Well, it comes the one came to Yehweh's servant the next morning on 10:06 on the Great Meher Shalal Kush Bazmir. So 8:29 is actually the day, but the last day of my 42nd day of my affliction would be 828. Who could make it up? And again, 828 is day number 990, belly, the living waters that flow up from my belly. Day number 990 of Operation Olive Branch. In case you don't know, the second dove brought back, the second stroke brought back the olive branch, symbolic of Yehweh's second son of his holy anointing oil. Who could make it up? Whatever, keep living in rebellion to our maker. Whatever. That day, I did video number 1564, but you have judged your maker. You've judged your maker that day I did a video. Boy, have you ever judged him. In stealing from him, you're saying that I'm not his anointed. You've judged him to be a liar, for one. Because the testimony of his word, all of it, testifies he sent me. You judged our maker. But you judged the way he sent forth the Emmanuel man-child in speaking against me. No different. The first time, 9/11, that he and I were reviled on the account of the manner he sent forth the Emmanuel man-child. I was probably reviled by other people before then. We had, the website was down and different things for a period of time. But I was probably reviled before then. But it was the first time when I got the phone turned back on and I was able to retrieve my messages. So I don't know why the message didn't go away because the phone was disconnected. But the first time I was reviled to my faces. It was on the phone. But I hadn't received any reviling emails at that point. I hadn't received any reviling phone calls until that day, 9/11. 5777. Suppose the events of 9/11/2001 are just a coincidence, especially since it's recorded in his Meher Shalal Kushbash prophecy about them tearing down the translated sycamore tree and planting an evergreen, but it's actually fig tree, planting an evergreen. But anyway, in Isaiah 9, they're going to rebuild, the bricks are falling down. The events of 9/11 are part of the Meher Shalal Kushbash prophecy. You can't make it up, folks. You can't make it up. Turn back or you're getting ready to die. Your children are getting ready to die. Because you're utter rebellion to our maker. But all truly amazing. 85th night was last night of the shofars. Although I do get to confess, I did not hear him. I assume I'll hear him tomorrow. Tonight, my tooth was really bothering me and different things last night, this morning. So I didn't hear it. But I'm sure they were blowing. But 85th night of Hagar conceived Ishmael. How that ties into Isaiah chapter 21 with the year of the hireling, that when we hire to bring our waters up here and stuff, met us with waters and bread. Amazing, but how that ties into the 85 priests that Saul had dogged the Edomite kill. Now, that's pretty cool too. But of course, Hagar gave birth when Abraham was 86, but Abraham was 85 when she conceived. But the 84th night, the night before, I had dual dreams, one on China and one on the Key of David. Pretty much visions, dreams or visions, however you want to look at it. But truly, because I'm awake when I have them, but I guess you can call them vision. But Key of David, the China missile dream vision. But here's what the vision was. It was I was in the room, although they couldn't see me, with the Chinese, and they're like mission control room, I guess you call it, and on their screens, they're showing the people hit missiles, and the missiles are on their way to America, just missile after missile, and they're just dialing, I guess, coordinates and missile, just hitting whole room full of people, just hitting missiles, and they say they don't have that many missiles, really. I don't know that many people, but I think they have that many ballistic missiles that can reach here. Who knows what they got besides Yehweh? But it's just hundreds of missiles. And the screen is just showing up these missiles going across the world, around the globe, headed for America. And it's more detailed than that, but I'm going to summarize it. But then I was in the American control room, and everything's quiet. The screens are all bare. Everything's quiet. And all of a sudden, the phone rings, and the general there picks up the phone, and he hangs up the phone, and he says, folks, he says, turns out they did something, the Chinese did something to our whatever, and I can't remember the word, but some their systems, but they had a word too for it. And we're not picking up this, but it's been visually reported that there are just hundreds and hundreds of missiles, maybe thousands of missiles, and the first ones will hit in less than 200 seconds. And he kept talking about it a little bit, and he said now less than 2.5 minutes, the two things he said. And you tell he's a little distraught because they don't really know what to do. They don't have this in their playbook, you know. And then the phone rings again. He picks up the phone and he sets down the phone and he says, well, the pin's been pulled. And he walked around the counter there of the computer screens, and they were all, the whole room of them. and everybody's kind of got their jaws dropped in the room. Nobody, but you could hear a pin drop. It's so quiet. And he took his coffee cup over there, same coffee cup that I woke up from the dream to. I don't have coffee. I have some tea in the morning, but pre-Sabbath, the wife gets up and brews some tea. And so it's still in a thermos type of thing, so it's still warm. It's like the same cup. And it looked like the same one anyway in the vision. And he opens up it's about identical to the wine cup, so it could have been the silver wine cup even, but he put waters in it. He goes over and turns on the water. It was like a spracket like this, turns on the water, puts some water in it. Fall into the prophecy with watering down your wine, with watering down Yehweh's blood, but his only begotten son shed blood. But anyway, then he walks around and I could see him. We walk around and he did his part of turning the key, I guess, to send the nuclear. But that delay, he was just sober as could be, because it's a little day late, a dollar short. We're already hitting, basically, pretty much by the time he's turning the switch. Already hitting. That's amazing. Because his Emmanuel Manchild Meher Shalal Kushbaz say, you ain't going to see this coming. It's going to hit you suddenly, like a ton of bricks. And boy, I tell you what, the screens were just full of missiles. It was quite the deal. And then the Key of David dream, which is not going to go into the details of that, but I received an email yesterday from a man that asked me, when did I first see the vision of Yellowstone blowing? And I had to think about that a little bit, but pretty positive it was 2009. The significance of that is 11 days journey, because 11 months would prove that it's going to be 2020. But I didn't keep notes and I didn't write down the date. But if I did write down the date, I'm sure it's to the date, probably on Satan's calendar, of whenever Yellowstone's going to blow. But Yellowstone was the first vision of destruction that he gave to me, the first. The second one was of the West Coast tsunami. And I've had others like this China vision. But the West Coast tsunami, the 1-2 punch, I'm sure it's going to get started that way. And I think China and Russia are going to raise them up to follow. Because I've said that in other videios too, America's going to be down. Yellowstone's going to blow, the West Coast tsunami. But can you imagine those men knowing that Yellowstone's blown in that room and the West Coast tsunami's wiped out the West Coast? And all of a sudden, now they don't even know the missiles are on their way until they almost hit. Because they did something to their some system. This is a vision. I didn't write down the word, but it was some sort of a name for something I never heard of before. But they're basically their amazing guard there at NORAD or whatever. That's probably where it was at, inside of NORAD where I seen them. But wow, the Key of David, I said throughout these videos, you could substitute. They've been given my hand, Isaiah 22. Key of David's going to give. I'm going to get the judge, the robe's judge, the value determiner. I'm going to get his robe, the value determiner, Shibna. Anyway, in that Isaiah 22. But I'm going to have his robe put on because I'm the judge that will be in those days. But anyway, it's also in the revelations of his two sons of his holy anointing oil with the called out ones of Philadelphia, which he doesn't offer any admonishment to the called out ones of Philadelphia. Does the other six groups. And of course, then he goes into Ephesus for number seven. Philadelphia's number six. Six sevens, of course, is 42. But I'm going to reject here and jump back. 10:05 on Satan's calendar. The next day, that night, Ezekiel 33, End Time Son of Adam, chapter 33, talks about the next day, referring to 10:06. I've said the next day, 10:06 throughout these videos, because that's what the prophecy says. The city smitten, 10:05. The next day, the opening of right in my mouth. On Satan's, that's amazing. Anyway, unless it's just another warning, but boy, 9:05 is only 7 days later. Wow, that's 49 days. How that ties into the Daniel prophecy is amazing too, for the first seven sevens, 49, Michael. Excuse me, is the 9:05, 10:12 waypoint. Even the Passover. Since Yehweh plucked me from your midst, we've done 10 Passovers, going back to the two in Greece, but 10 Passovers plus the two backup Passovers. He's had four feasts, backup feasts, but of the second month, but only two of them did we do the backup Passover. So 10 and 12 on Satan's calendar is at 9:05, 266 day. You can't make it up. But the Key of David, we can substitute Yeshua's references to himself or my references to myself, and to know the key into the kingdom of the dual heavens, and substituting Yehweh's, the name that he gave to us. And of course, he's given me lots of names, Yehweh's the Kinyu, different things. But the word of Elohim, Revelation 19, and now understanding that applies to me, because I am his words written upon me, even more so than Yeshua, because only partial prophecies on Yeshua. But we substitute Yeshua's name for him, the name, the word of Elohim, because he was sitting in the image of the Yehweh's word too. But I am the way, I am life. No one could come to the Father. I am the pathway. I am life. I am the truth. No one can come to the Father except through the pathway of me. The word of Elohim is the pathway. The word of Elohim is life. The word of Elohim is truth. No one can come to the Father except through the pathway of the word of Elohim. That's the key of David. And that's amazing. How it's tied into a vision and the teaching your children. I'm not going to go into the vision because this is already long. But call out and give me a key. An open door that no man can close and a closed door that no man can open. It's just what it is. But I have opened it for you with the key of David. All you got to do is the word of Elohim is the light. It's life. And it's the light of the world. The word of Elohim. It's just, I am the good shepherd. The word of Elohim is the good shepherd. It's not complicated, folks. I'm the straight and narrow pathway. The word of Elohim is the straight and narrow pathway. It's not complicated. I am the truth. The word of Elohim is the truth. The truth will set you free. John 17:17. From the captivity of the lies that our Maker gave you into, and count of him honoring your rebellious, uncircumcised hearts and wanting to live in rebellion to him. Truly amazing. All this stuff, 2020 elections is coming together now. I'm not going to go into all that. The SCOTUS, the nominee, how they're going to start the hearings on 10-12. All that's truly amazing. But my affliction will indeed come to an end. I believe these 42 days. And straightway, the sun is going to not give. The sun is going to go dark and the moon is not going to give her light. And the stars from the dual heavens are going to fall. You'll see the sign of the Son of Adam. 3 days and three nights, how that ties into the sign of the Son of Adam. Yehweh's restored calendar. Wow, look at how I did. I'm talking about it. And also the great Mahershala Kushbaz mirror, but 10:5 and 10:6 the next day. Truly, truly amazing. The sign of the Son of Adam was 3 days and three nights. One final tier of 3 days and three nights. Boy, he's woven in tons of them in his warning cry. He sent me away, including yesterday morning at 7:34. That was huge. 8:8 is not going away. 8:8 ties into the 1150 morning and evenings of the 2300 morning, 1150 mornings and 1150 evenings of the substitution sacrifice that he set up through his two sons of his holy anointing oil. Daniel chapter 8, 2300 morning and evenings took us to 327, which 328 at 7:34 a.m. The day he spent his sign of the dove out from the belly of the ocean traversing plain back in 5772 on June 19th, 2012. 30 days before the July 19th waypoint. Amazing. 3 days and three nights. One final tier. And I'll look at this from a ton of different ways. I haven't looked at it yet because it's new. It's hot off the press because I thought yesterday was it. But yesterday's 8:22 at 7:34 a.m. waypoint. And that 3 days and three nights is huge because what will you have then when you have, and I'll have to look at it. I'll have to look at it closer so I don't mess up here because, 7 days later, which would be the seven strokes, would be 7:34 a.m. on 8:29, which 8:29 on Satan's calendar is when he caused me to remove it was 10:10 when the first day his house was uncovered, but 8:29, which would be 10:06 on Satan's calendar at 7:34 a.m. But the China vision preceded this 7:34 a.m. waypoint yesterday morning. Preceded it. So I don't know exactly how that all takes into it. It might be 10:05 because the city is smitten. 10:05 might very well be when Yellowstone blows and a 1-2 punch with the West Coast tsunami. But folks, can't you see? One clothed with the persuasion, with my persuasion, and the blood of the grapes standing before your faces. The testimony of his words written upon me. I mean, again, go back and listen to just a simple little thing like 9:30 plus Mordecai, the signature ring, and go back 55 days prior to today. It's today's 9:30 waypoint. Satan. Go back 55 days prior to today, and that's 6:28, and different things. I had written on my notes that little square in that place, 9:30 plus 8 months and 28 days. I don't even know why I did that. There was no significance to 8 months and 28 days at that time. Why did I write that? Meaning the reviling plus 8 months and 28 days, was that 6:28 waypoint, Hurricane Michael? The box, you open up that order number, 628, 2 years earlier was the 600th day of me approaching near to him, three strokes a day at his house. The house that was destroyed for the one great evil on 930. I mean, I'm skimming over details still, but don't you have any fear? Don't you have any fear of our Maker? Any whatsoever? Don't you have any belief that maybe maybe the testimony of his word is true, especially since you say it's true? Obviously not.